So I'm Kapil Dev Singh. I'm the founder of Mishmi Takin. और इससे पहले कि मैं Mishmi Takin की बात करूँ, I think I should talk about myself first. I did my B.Tech in civil engineering from IIT Delhi, just down the road. उसके बाद I gave civil services and I joined railways. So I was in Indian Railways in Mumbai for 5 years. Then I left the government service and went to US. I went to MIT doing my master's in logistics and supply chain. And then I worked in consulting, supply chain consulting and corporate America for 7-8 years. And I did not like it that much. So I left that and I went to West Africa. Liberia. So I joined Clinton Foundation and I lived in Liberia for a year and a half. I did that and then I came back to US, did consulting for a little while with the same result. I didn't like it that much. And at that point, after that, you know, I wanted to do something of my own. So when I was in US, I was very much into running and hiking and all that. And I just happened to Google, you know, hiking shoes in India. And I think I saw one shoe which I had never heard of. And then I saw women's heel sandals in the results. And I just could not understand what the link was between the two. So that sort of gave me the idea that, you know, maybe there is something here and there is a need. And I came across a forum, India Mike, which had more than 1,000 comments about how shitty the footwear is. and then the very next month, I happened to be in Mishmi Hills in Arunachal Pradesh. And after spending some rainy days there and talking to the locals there, I realized, you know, that the need for good quality gear is more widespread than just the hiking community. So that became the starting point for Mishmi Takin. And because the idea came from the Mishmi Hills in Arunachal Pradesh, so that's where the Takin, which is a rare goat antelope found in that area. So we named the company after Mishmi Takin. So Mishmi Takin has a couple of characteristics. It lives very far away from mankind in remote areas. And then, you know, it is a goat, so it has excellent footing. And then it also has a waterproof, like it has a coating on its fur to withstand the whole tropical rainy environment. So we got some of the ideas for Mishmi Takin from Mishmi Takin. When I went to Boston for doing my master's, you know, I heard about the Boston Marathon, most famous marathon of them all. And then I was like, oh yeah, I want to run a marathon, you know. And I used to run before that, but you know, I was running maybe like 4 or 5 kilometers, you know, half an hour. I think that was the maximum I had run before that. But when I got there and I saw so many people, you know, training for a marathon and running a marathon and all that, that gave me a film, like made me very excited. And I decided that I'm going to run a marathon. So it took me a while, you know. So it took me, I think, 3 years, you know, and multiple tries before I actually ran a marathon. I still haven't ran Boston Marathon, but you know, I got into running with that. And from 2007 to 2012, I was doing a marathon every year before I hurt myself. It took a couple of years to recover from the injury, and then I again did 2 marathons in the last 6 months. So I've done like 8 marathons by now. I actually like to run. And then when I was again in Boston, when I joined MIT, like in the very first week, they took us on an orientation hike into the White Mountains in New Hampshire. And I just loved it. And so I started hiking very regularly there. And so MIT has a outing club called the MIT Outing Club. So they do what they call a winter school. So during the month of January, they hold classes and lectures, and and then take you out into the mountains. So you do, you know, basically you do winter hiking, ice climbing, snowshoeing, and all those activities. And I was really, you know, enthused by that. Again, it took me a little while, you know, because I needed to get, so I attended the lectures, but I didn't have money for the gear and all that. Took me 2-3 years before I could fully get into it, but so I did hiking there, and it was fantastic. I really love White Mountains, and so that was the background. I was basically a hiker and a user myself. And then when I was here in India and I was hiking in the Mishmi Hills, and that's when I sort of realized that my gear, which used to work fine in Boston, does not necessarily work here in India. And it's because the conditions are so radically different. And I realized that, you know, most of the brands, most of the international brands, take anyone, North Face, Patagonia, anyone, all of them are designing for conditions in Boston, New York, and, you know, more cold conditions, cold and dry. And that does not necessarily work in a hot and humid kind of condition. So that became the core idea behind Mishmi Takin, that we will design for all these conditions which no one designs for, and we're going to make a great product. And that's the kind of running philosophy behind what we are doing. So, I mean, what I saw at MIT was that actually the academic people are actually very much into the outdoors. It's very common. And so you will find someone who is astrophysicist, and he's also very much into, you know, hiking and mountaineering and all that. And, you know, so one thing which I still have not done in my life and I wanted to do is to become an astronaut. Hopefully one day. But, you know, you find that, you know, so it is very common. So there is a lot of link between, for example, being an astronaut and being a mountaineer. Because in both things, you are dealing with an extreme environment in which the objective risk is so high, and it is it's basically all about managing that risk. So it is very common to find somebody who is an astronaut, who is an astrophysicist, and who is also a mountaineer, because there is actually a big link between them. And also, when you are intensively into academics and all that, this gives you such a great outing. It helps you, you know, clear up your mind and think about other things. And especially, and you are in nature, in a bit of solitude, it gives you actually time to think as well. I think of myself, you know, I like to run. So when I go running, I find that all the problems that I'm dealing with, I solve them while I'm running. I don't think, you know, about anything. I just go running, and you know, you decide what to do, you know, and it's peaceful. And I run to actually get away from everything. So it's actually very common. And also, one thing I've realized over the years is a healthy mind resides in a healthy body. So you cannot be really highly productive if you are, you know, completely if your body is not in good shape. So it's a little bit of a thing about entrepreneurship, which I have found, is that you start with a certain idea in mind, but it evolves, and you know, sometimes it takes on a life of its own. When I started, I did not have this broad, you know, this much specific an idea. What I thought was that, okay, we are going to make a product with Indian conditions in mind. And then a couple of things happened. One is that I saw, at that time, like Decathlon was just coming up. I saw that, and I realized, you know, we are not going to be competing with them on price and quality and all that. And then, you know, so one decision I made was that we're going to be as far away from them as possible, that nobody ever confuses us with Decathlon, you know. So we are going to make the best possible product. And things happen. One is that, like, I initially, like everybody says, go to China. So I actually went to China, and we made some initial prototypes, and you know, they looked very good, but when we went for field testing, they failed miserably. And that kind of completely dented my confidence in the whole Chinese endeavor. So I shifted completely from there, and then I said, you know, when we are making hiking boots, the best, you know, in the world are produced by Italians, so we are going to Italy. So we made the best possible product, and with certain specific conditions in mind, and at that point the thing was that, okay, if we are making the best possible product, we should be selling it, you know, everywhere. And I showed them at a trade show in US, and we got a great response, and so at that point I said, okay, let us first, you know, launch it in US and, you know, get some validation and independent, you know, so let us build our credibility before we get into India. So we launched there, and we have been getting great, you know, we have gotten great reviews. So like Men's Health last year had declared our boots to be the best backpacking boot, and we just got the Editor's Choice Award from Fish Alaska magazine, and then Backpacker just last week featured us in the in their magazine as the most breathable waterproof boot, you know. So their tester says it's the most breathable she's ever worn. So and similarly our jackets also were picked as the best hard shell of 2017. So we've been getting great response, great feedback from the market, and now we are finally planning to launch in India.